Summer Social at Cast On Yarn Studios.
Yes, and I'm here with Laura, so please tell me all of your businesses.
Okay, well, I'm an indie dyer for Creative For You by Laura, and I also am the new owner for the Pittsburgh Creative Arts Festival, which is actually happening this year as an in-person event in August.
Wow.
So we're super, super excited about that. It's my first time, over 50 classes, 50-some-odd vendors. Mm-hmm. It's a three-day event, August 12th, 13th, and 14th. And it's at the Doubletree Hotel in Green Tree, Pennsylvania, right outside of Pittsburgh.
I love it. I didn't know that you could own a festival.
Yes.
Now I want one. I used to think I wanted like a castle in France, but now I think I want a festival.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know how it goes.
Now, do you also have a yarn shop?
No. Okay. I'm just an indie dyer. I do mostly festivals and then trunk shows like at Cast On Yarn Studios.
How long have you been doing this?
So I've been dyeing with my husband for about 5-6 years now. So it's our later in life career.
Love that.
He's a chef, mm-hmm. So kind of that mixing creativity that he brings to the table. Mm-hmm. So we dye together, mm-hmm. which has its ups and downs.
Good. Thank you for being honest, because I was about to say, how is that?
Well, he sees color differently than I do, mm-hmm. so it's great. Mm-hmm. I mean, from a mixing perspective, he'll go, I'm going to put these together. And I'm like, okay, honey, go ahead.
But then
it comes out, and it's like, wow, mm-hmm. I would have never done that.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I was just speaking to Felicia Lowe of Sweet Georgia. I don't know mm-hmm. if you're familiar with her. And she said she hired someone who had just come out of culinary school because she knew he would be precise in the studio space.
Yes.
So I had never thought of that before. Like you turn here and then you turn here and then you do this movement.
Yeah.
Does that resonate with you?
Well, yeah. And he's very meticulous.
Yes.
Right? So it's almost, it's a line. Like in the mm-hmm. kitchen, there's a kitchen line.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a dyeing line. And I'm like, nope, you can't go there, he says. And I'm like, okay, I'll stay over here.
Yeah, isn't that interesting?
It is.
So why did you turn to this as your later in life career? Did you have a background in fiber knitting?
So no, actually I'm a knitter. Mm-hmm. I've knitted for decades. Mm-hmm. So way back in the 80s when I was in college, I actually wrote a business plan for a brick and mortar yarn shop.
Wow.
So fast forward 40 some odd years or 55 some odd years, and instead of the brick and mortar, we did indie dyeing.
Yeah.
And we're hitting the festival circuit, we're having lots of fun, figured we could see mm-hmm. the country a little bit, yeah. make it little mini vacations, mm-hmm. and off we go.
Yeah. Love it when you can expense your...
Yes.
Your trip.
Very true.
You know?
Very
like
true.
Sometimes I'm going, okay, well, yes, it's our vacation, but could I put a little work into this? So it's so nice.
Yes.
Love that. Yeah. Okay, what are you wearing today?
So I'm wearing Ripple Lake Cardigan by Hohe Locatelli. Mm. And this is in our hand-dyed yarns. It's our sock fingering weight, sassy stash, we call it. And as you can see, we're pretty bright.
Yeah.
We're all about color.
Mm-hmm.
The brighter, the better, mm-hmm. the different. Most people walk into our booth and either go, wow, or, oh, I'm scared. So we get both reactions. The wow is kind of like, okay, they'll probably buy something. The, oh, I'm scared. We have some conversations and we talk about
yeah.
it. And sometimes they'll be comfortable and sometimes they're not, but
yeah.
that's okay.
Yeah. We need to teach some people that a little pop, you know, like a little pop on the cuff.
Yes.
You know, a little pop somewhere with your neutrals is like...
It's okay.
What you need.
With a gray, a nice color,
yeah.
or even blues, or, you know, the off-whites. And everything looks brighter in a skein.
Yes, yeah, so let's
see. So this is... my husband actually dyed this in honor of you.
Oh, thank
so
you.
So this is the Summer Social 2021 exclusive.
I love it.
And when I showed him a picture of you and told him what I wanted to do, he was like, okay, I get the pink. But then the blue is your eyes.
Yes.
So you kind of have more greeny blue eyes today.
It depends on the
day. But in some of the pictures. So we put the blue in for your eyes, and then the pink is for all the pink that you wear. And this was his interpretation of you.
I love it. And this is merino and tencel.
Yeah, so this is a base that I don't see a lot of people carry.
Oh.
It's fingering weight. The merino is the wool, obviously, and the tencel is plant-based, mm-hmm. based from eucalyptus.
Mm-hmm.
That gives it the shine
yeah.
and the drape.
Yeah.
So garments made with this really hold its shape, but it has a really nice shine to it, mm-hmm. sheen almost, mm-hmm. kind of silk-like, mm-hmm. but not silk prices.
Yeah, I was going to say, is this silk?
No. Awesome. And then here's another new base. We call this is a slub base. Mm-hmm. And again, different combination of colors. It has the texture to it. It's better on larger hooks or needles mm-hmm. so that you get the little knobbies coming through.
Mm-hmm. Love that.
And that's a lot of fun. This is our tweed.
This is called Glacier Bay.
Yeah, right? That's the color. Okay, yeah. Yeah. And then this is a tweed. Mm. So you see the little nubs of the black and gray running through it. Mm-hmm. So it gives it a little tweed-like effect when knitted up. And we usually put most of our colors on our yarn so people can find matches to it.
Love it.
Versus naming. Mm-hmm. And then here's a lighter version. We do some pastels or lighter colors mm-hmm. in the same tweed.
Mm. I love that mint in there and a little peach.
Yes.
This reminds me of the Golden Girls living room.
Oh yeah.
Those colors going on.
Very
in their
true.
Little Miami, right? Weren't they like Florida?
Yeah,
or something?
I think they were in Florida.
I don't know, love it.
So we have lots of fingering weight, DK and sport weight. Mm-hmm. Sport weight's kind of new.
Yeah. It's coming on the scene.
Yeah, it's in between the DK and the fingering. And I think it's neat to work with.
Yeah.
But yeah, so if you're in the area, come up and see me. Check me out online. I'm on Instagram and Facebook. And if you're in Pittsburgh, hit up our festival.
Yeah. So I'm going to put all of those links underneath this video so that you can actually check them out. And I so enjoyed getting to know you today.
Thank you so much.
So thanks for this little mini interview.
Thanks. That's wonderful.
And we'll see you next time.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.